In continuation, let's discuss the sample connection of voltmeters in various circuits. Here in first figure, we can see a voltmeter is connected in parallel across the resistance R2. So due to this battery, a current flows through the circuit and a potential difference across R2 can be measured using this voltmeter. Similarly, there are two voltmeters V1, V2 connected across the parallel combinations of resistance R1 as well as R2. And for ideal voltmeters, we can see that the resistance of voltmeter is infinite. So, ignoring the presence of these voltmeters, remaining circuit we can solve by using Kirchhoff's voltage law or Kirchhoff's current law, and we can find out the current in this loop. So that current and multiplication with this resistance give us the potential difference across R1, which is read by this voltmeter. Similarly, the product of current and this resistance is the potential difference across these terminals, which is read by the voltmeter V2. Because V1 and V2 are connected in parallel across R1 and R2. Similarly, here you can see this voltmeter V1 is connected across these two terminals. So, this is a parallel combination across this whole group. So, in this situation, using KVL, we can find out the potential difference across these two, which is read by voltmeter V1. And your V2 is connected in parallel combination across R3. So, this voltmeter will give the reading of potential difference across resistance R3. Similarly, here you can see this voltmeter V1 gives a reading of potential difference across these two terminals. It is connected in parallel with the series combination of this battery of EMF V1 and resistance R2. And this voltmeter V2 is connected across these terminals. So it will directly read the potential difference across these two terminals. And theoretically, we can calculate it by writing KVL equation from this point to this point. So, you can see this is the way by which we can connect voltmeter across any two points of a circuit across which we wish to directly measure the potential difference by using the deflection type meter voltmeter.